The YouTuber Jesus Christ, real name Jesus H. Christ, has been accused of sexual misconduct by another smaller YouTuber. These are obviously some pretty serious allegations. Jesus Christ has become a pretty big YouTuber as of late. He's gone viral on a number of occasions, and that's a lot to do with the fact that PewDiePie has been supporting him. Well, in a video uploaded to his channel, Jesus Christ denies these Me Too allegations, and I'm gonna tell you everything you need to know right now on Inform Overload. You thought I was gonna say I owe, didn't you? Welcome back to Inform Overload, I'm Charlotte Dobre. Why don't you smash that subscribe for updates on news stories that are actually relevant to you. So right now, I'm gonna talk about a topic that is very dear to my heart, the Me Too movement. It started when several Hollywood actresses came forward with sexual misconduct allegations about Hollywood producer Harvey Weinstein. You probably heard about it, but as a result, millions upon millions of people started sharing their own stories of sexual misconduct and assault using the hashtag MeToo. Only then did the world realize how widespread the problem really is. Sexual misconduct, especially in the workplace, is an issue that's been rampant in all industries. It's not something that only happens to women. It happens to men, people of color, and members of the LGBT community. The problem is the movement has some bad eggs, where people falsely accuse someone of significance of sexual misconduct. A very small percentage of reported sexual misconduct is false or baseless, somewhere between 2 and 10%. But every time someone does falsely accuse someone and gets found out, it makes people lose trust in those who are being truthful about their accusations. Jesus H. Christ is a YouTuber who escaped from a religious cult. He's been receiving a lot of attention lately because he's currently going through a custody battle where he could lose his children to the religious cult. You may have seen this video. It's called Jesus Christ Needs Your Help. We even covered it on this channel. It's clickable on the screen right now if you haven't seen that, but I won't spend too much time talking about it right now. Basically, PewDiePie shared Jesus' GoFundMe for his lawyer's fund, and it helped him get to 900,000 subscribers. I guess another smaller YouTuber wanted to use his experience with Jesus H. Christ and Jesus' recent popularity for his own gain. The God of Cringe is a YouTuber with 16,000 subscribers. In a video on his channel uploaded on January 8th, the God of Cringe said he wanted to expose Jesus for who he really is. The God of Cringe alleges that while at VidCon 2.5 years ago, Jesus made him unbutton his shirt, revealing his nipple, and then Jesus took out a marker and started touching his nipple, making him very uncomfortable. The God of Cringe offered no evidence of this encounter, but he did say that he believed Jesus was using the video for his own pleasure, if you know what I mean. The thing is, plot twist, Jesus Christ did have footage of this encounter and provided the footage in question in his video, "I'm being accused of sexual misconduct." The entire time, the footage clearly shows this YouTuber egging Jesus on, quite obnoxiously in fact. Essentially, he was asking for and happy about the autograph. Jesus also clearly asks for consent to give this autograph, noting that the God of Cringe already had a drawing on his chest of a penis. So clearly, the God of Cringe's accusations were a lie. And that's pretty terrible. Fake allegations like this make the whole Me Too movement lose credibility. What about all the people who have experienced horrible instances of sexual misconduct and abuse? And like, damn, you had to turn an autograph into sexual misconduct allegations? Maybe this is gonna make YouTubers hesitant to give autographs to their fans at all because it means they have to touch them. So like, God of Cringe might have ruined that for everybody. The God of Cringe has since uploaded two apology videos to his channel. The first one called I'm Sorry Jesus Christ Channel. It's about 3.5 hours long. Didn't watch the whole thing, to be honest. And the second is called The God of Cringe Apology to Jesus Christ Channel, where he apologizes and said he was relying on his memory, which faded. God of Cringe said that he didn't have the video that Jesus shared on his channel. Thankfully, from how many dislikes the God of Cringe got, it's clear that most people didn't believe his allegations. I should also say that these allegations could have seriously damaged Jesus H. Christ's custody battle for his children. So, pretty awful. Anyways, guys, that is all I have for you on that. Don't let this story give you less faith in other Me Too stories. For now, I'm gonna wrap up this video with some calmer replies. PurPurCat said, I subscribe and turn on post notifications. Thank you for subbing, welcome to the squad. Psycho Girl Forever said, I love all the videos on this channel. Well, I love you, Psycho Girl Forever. It's Me Gunner said, can you say Hey Gunner in the next video, please? Hey Gunner. Are you happy now? Jerry Fegerberger said, I'm so gangster, I'm watching this at school in class. Educational, am I right? Very right, but please don't get detention. The Zombie Killer said, is Ligma banned now? I hope not, I got Ligma in New York. Welcome to the end screen, this means the video is over. To keep watching, check out that playlist. And make sure you like, sub, and turn on those notifications so I can see you in the next IO video.